नमस्कार, हेलो एंड वेलकम टू एनसीईआरटीज लाइव फोन इन प्रोग्राम। मेरा नाम है तन्वी खुराना और मैथ्स की इस क्लास में आज जिस विषय पर हम चर्चा करेंगे वो है पॉलिनोमियल्स और ये इसका दूसरा भाग है। अगर आप सभी ने पहला भाग नहीं देखा है तो मैं आप सभी से कहना चाहूंगी कि आप हमारे YouTube चैनल पर जाइए एनसीईआरटी ऑफिशियल और उस पर पहला भाग जरूर देखिए। दोनों भाग आपस में जुड़े हुए हैं। नवी कक्षा के सभी छात्र इस वक्त हमें देख सकते हैं पीएमई विद्या चैनल नंबर 9 पर और हमारे साथ एक एक्सपर्ट मौजूद है जो हमें पॉलिनोमियल्स के बारे में सब कुछ बताएंगे। कैंपियन स्कूल भोपाल से हमारे साथ है मिस उषा पिल्ले। स्वागत है आपका मैम।
यस, गुड आफ्टरनून।
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम। सो मैम विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट पॉलिनोमियल्स। इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चन प्लीज प्लीज फील फ्री टू सेंड इट टू अस on our email ID which is dth.class9@ciet.nic.in and if you want to know the details of our programs, agar kaun si class ka kaun sa subject kaun sa topic kis din aane wala hai ye aap jankari janna chahte hain to aapko hamari website par visit karna hoga ya swayam prabha ki website ya ciet ki website aur wahan par aapko ye sab jankari mil jayegi। हमारे टाइम टेबल हमारा शेड्यूल तो आपसे देखना बिल्कुल मत भूलिएगा और अपने सवाल हम तक पहुंचाते रहिएगा। तो आइए मैम से पूछते हैं कि भाग एक में मैम ने आप सभी को और हम सभी को क्या पढ़ाया था, क्या समझाया था और आज जो भाग दो है उसमें मैम हमें किस बारे में चर्चा करने वाली है। मैम।
यस, गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स। इन द लास्ट सेशन वी स्टडीड अबाउट definition of polynomials, terms of polynomials, types of polynomials, degree of a polynomial and zeros of a polynomial. So as a recapitulation of last class, I am explaining simply the definition of polynomial, an expression involving variables, constants and operations involving addition, subtraction, multiplication and division is called a polynomial, where the exponents are cannot be negative or fractions. Now we can learn about the terms. There are so many terms in a polynomial. If it has one term, it is called a monomial, and if two terms, it is called a binomial, and three terms, it is known as trinomial. Now we have studied about polynomials in one variables, and also we have studied degree of a polynomial. The highest power of a polynomial is variable is called degree of a polynomial. According to the degree also we have studied. If the degree of a polynomial is 1, it is called a constant polynomial, a linear polynomial. And if the degree is 2, it is a quadratic polynomial. And the degree is 3, it is called a cubic polynomial. Suppose we are given a constant polynomial, then we can say the degree of constant polynomial is 1. And zero is also a zero polynomial, and the degree of zero polynomial is not defined up to now. Also, we studied about how to find the zeros of the polynomial. Now, in this session, we are discussing about some theorems related to polynomials, that is, remainder theorem and factor theorem. So, first, we can discuss about the remainder theorem. So, what is this remainder theorem? Let P of x be a polynomial of degree greater than or equal to 1 and let A be any real number. If P of x is divided by the linear polynomial x minus A, then the remainder is P of A. That means how to find the remainder by using remainder theorem. If we divide a polynomial by a linear polynomial by long division method, then also we can find the quotient and remainder. That is a lengthy process. But by using remainder theorem, we can easily find out the remainder when we divide a polynomial by a linear polynomial or quadratic polynomial. But here, we are discussing about if we divide it by a linear polynomial. For example, find the remainder when we divide x square plus 2x plus 1 is divided by x minus 2. How to divide? Without long division method, how to find the remainder? We can use the remainder theorem for that. First, we can find the zero of this linear polynomial x minus 2. In the last class, we studied how to find the zero of this polynomial. Zero of x minus 2 is x is equal to plus 2. That term totally becomes zero when the value of x we substitute. So x is equal to 2 is the zero of the polynomial, and we can substitute the value of x in place of the given polynomial. That is, remainder is equal to p of 2. That is 2 square plus 2 into 2 plus 1. That is, 2 square is 2 into 2. 4 plus 4 plus 1. That is 9. In this way, very easily, we can find the remainder when we divide the polynomial of higher degree by a linear polynomial. Now, let us study about factor theorem. What is factor theorem? Already we have studied, if we divide a number 6 by 3, we get the quotient 2 and the remainder as 0. If we get the remainder as 0, we can say 3 is a factor of 6. Just like here, if p of x is a polynomial of degree greater than or equal to 1 and a is any real number, then x minus a is a factor of p of x if p of a equal to 0. That means if the remainder we are getting is 0, we can say x minus a is a factor of the given polynomial. Now, there are two steps. Second is p of a equal to 0, that is remainder equal to 0, if x minus a is a factor of p of x. Suppose we are given x minus a is a factor of p of x. Therefore, the 0 of x minus a is p of plus a. We can put p of a equal to 0, and we can find out an unknown value is given in a polynomial, except x or y, then we can find out the value of that unknown variable by the second step. X minus a is a factor, we can substitute remainder equal to 0, and we can find the value. Here, we can check x minus 1 is a factor of x square minus 2x plus 1 or not. How to check? By using factor theorem, we can do it. First, we are using remainder theorem for finding out the remainder, that is, p of plus 1 equal to 1 square. In place of this x, we are substituting the value as 1 square minus 2 into 1 plus 1 equal to 2 minus 2, that is 0. So, here the remainder is equal to 0. Therefore, by factor theorem, we can say x minus 1 is a factor of p of x. That is, when we are dividing a polynomial by a linear polynomial and if we get the remainder as 0, we can say it is a factor. This is factor theorem. And by using this factor theorem, we are saying this x minus 1 is a factor of p of x. Now, next, we can apply these theorems in some of the questions. How to apply these theorems? First, find the remainder when x cube plus 3x square plus 3x plus 1 is divided by x minus 1 by 2. When we divide by x minus 1 by 2, we have to find the 0 of this x minus 1 by 2 first. That is, x is equal to 1 by 2. When we substitute 1 by 2 here, 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 is 0. That is the 0 of the polynomial. Now, by remainder theorem, we know how to find the remainder. That is, p of 1 by 2. We substitute the value of x as 1 by 2 in this given polynomial. So 1 by 2 the whole cube plus 3 into 1 by 2 the whole square plus 3 into 1 by 2 plus 1. So in the next step, we got 1 by 2 the whole cube is 1 upon 8 and 3 upon 4 plus 3 upon 2 plus 1. When we take the LCM of 8, 4 and 2, you know the LCM is 8. So by finding equivalent fractions of each fraction given, we get the answer as 27 upon 8. There, it is given. So 1, 4 2s are 8, so 2 3s are 6. 2 6 are 2 4s are 8, so 4 3s are 12. Plus the denominator of this is 1. 1 into 8 is 8, so multiplied by 8. So adding this 1 plus 6 plus 12 plus 8, we got 27 upon 8 as the remainder. This is the easy method for finding out. If we use long division method for finding out the remainder by x minus 1 by 2, that is a very lengthy process. You can very easily use this method for doing this question. Next is find the remainder when we divide x cube minus ax square plus 6x minus a is divided by x minus a. Here also you know the zero of this polynomial is x is equal to plus a. So by remainder theorem we can find the remainder. We put the value of x as a. So here x cube, so a cube minus a into a square plus 6 into a minus a. That is a cube minus a cube plus 6a minus a. You can see a cube minus a cube is 0. So it is cancelled. So the next value 6a minus a is 5. So we got the remainder very easily. So now by using factor theorem, we can check whether 7 plus 3x is a factor of this 3x cube plus 7x or not. So here the linear polynomial given is 7 plus 3x. Suppose 7 plus 3x equal to 0, what will be the value of x? 7 right side mein jayega minus 7 upon 3. If 3x is given 3 into x, that is minus 7 upon 3 is the 0 of the polynomial. By remainder theorem, we can find the remainder. Substitute the value of x in the given polynomial by minus 7 upon 3 in place of x. 3 into minus 7 upon 3 the whole cube plus 7 into minus 7 upon 3. This minus 7 upon 3 the whole cube. 7 cube is 343. Minus into minus into minus, minus itself. 3 cube is 27. Minus. Plus into minus is minus. So 7 sevens are 49 upon 3. Now we take the LCM of this cube. 3 and 27 is cancelled. So we can get 9. So 9 and 3 is given, LCM is 9, and minus 343 minus 3, 3 is 9, so we can multiply it by 3. So it is equal to minus 343 minus 49 into 3 is 147. So the answer is minus 490 upon 9, that is not equal to 0. So we can say 7 plus 3x is not a factor of 3x cube plus 7x. Suppose we got the answer as 0, we can say it is a factor. Always, if we get remainder as 0, we can say that linear polynomial is a factor of the given polynomial. So the next is, check whether x plus 1 is a factor of x raised to 4 plus x cube plus x square plus x plus 1 or not. The same method we can use. We are taking this polynomial, given polynomial as p of x, that is x raised to 4 plus x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. So by remainder theorem, x plus, we are dividing by x plus 1. So we can put the value of x as minus 1. The 0 of x plus 1 is minus 1. So we substitute the value. We got minus 1 whole raised to 4 plus minus 4 whole raised to 3 plus minus 1 whole raised to 2 plus minus 1 plus 1. So here it is, minus 1 whole raised to 4 is 1. 1 minus 1 plus 1 minus 1 plus 1 is, all the terms are cancelling and we got the value as 1. That is not equal to 0. So we can say this given x plus 1 is not a factor of p of x. Now using the same theorem, determine whether g of x, that is a divisor, is a factor of p of x. When we are given p of x is equal to 2x cube plus x square minus 2x plus 1 and g of x is equal to x plus 1. So what is 0 of this polynomial? Minus 1. By remainder theorem we can find the remainder. 2 into minus 1 the whole cube plus minus 1 the whole square minus 2 into minus 1 minus 1. When we are finding out the values, minus 1, 2 into minus 1, the whole cube is minus 2, minus 1 into minus 1 is plus 1, minus into minus is plus 2, and here we got the answer as 0. So we can say by factor theorem, this given g of x is a factor of p of x. This is the use of factor theorem. If the remainder is 0, simply we can say the given linear polynomial is a factor of p of x. Now the second condition of factor theorem we are using in this question. Second condition was, if x minus 1 is a factor, we can say the remainder equal to 0. So The question is, find the value of k if x minus 1 is a factor of p of x. So question is, p of x equal to x square plus x plus k. We are given x minus 1 is a factor. So by factor theorem, we can say the remainder p of plus 1 equal to 0. Now we can substitute the value of x as plus 1. So when we are substituting, x square plus x plus k is given 1 square plus 1 plus k equal to 0. So 1 plus 1 is 2, 2 plus k equal to 0. Therefore, k is equal to minus 2. In this way, we can find the unknown value given in the polynomial. Now the second part, another question, p of x equal to x square minus root 2x plus 1. Here also we are given x minus 1 is a factor. So by factor theorem, we can say p of 1 is equal to 0. Now we can put the value of x as 1 here. Then k into 1 square minus root 2 into 1 plus 1 equal to 0. That is k minus root 2 into 1 is root 2 itself. Plus 1 equal to 0. Taking the constants on right side, we get k equal to root 2 minus 1. This will be the value of k. Now, from this, we can factorize the polynomials given. Last year, in 8th class, we have studied about how to factorize the polynomials if we are given a quadratic polynomial. And a quadratic polynomial, and also we were not given coefficient of x square. Now this year we are given the coefficient of x square in the polynomial. And the question is 12x square minus 7x plus 1. How to factorize it? So we have to multiply this 12 and 1. We get 12 into plus 1 is 12 itself. Now we have to find the factors of 12 to get 7 as the sum or difference. 4 3 are 12, 4 plus 3 is 7. But here minus 7 is given and the product is plus 12. So we can take both the numbers as minus. Minus 4, minus 3. Minus into minus is plus 12. And minus 4 plus minus 3 is minus 7. So we can split the middle term by using these factors. That is 12x square minus 7x plus 1 is equal to 12x square. Minus 4x minus 3x. Minus 7x is split as minus 4x minus 3x plus 1. Now we can take common factor from two terms. Here 4x is a common factor. The remaining part 4 3 is 12. X is taken, so 1x is remaining. 4x into 3x minus 1 minus. Here common factor may kuch diya nahi hai. So we are taking minus 1 as the common factor. Minus 1 into 3x. Minus of minus is plus, so here also minus is coming. Now in both the brackets, 3x minus 1 is a common factor. We have taken 3x minus 1 as common factor. The remaining part is 4x minus 1. So we got the factors of 12x square minus 7x plus 1 as 3x minus 1 into 4x minus 1. In this way, we can factorize this type of last year we have studied to factorize this by using identities also. We are thinking we can take a common factor or not. Second, we are thinking about identities. And then we can split the middle term. This type of questions cannot factorize by identities or taking only common factors. So we are using this middle split. Now in the second part, 6x square plus 5x minus 6. If we multiply coefficient of x square and constant term, 6 into minus 6 is minus 36. So 36, factors of 36 and 5, we are getting 9 into 4 is 36 and 9 minus 4 is 5. So 9 into minus 4 is minus 36. Both the conditions satisfied. Product is minus and the sum is plus. So we can split the middle term as 6x square plus 9x minus 4x minus 6. Here also we are taking the common factor from the first two terms. 3x is a common factor, so 2x plus 3. Here minus 2 is a common factor, so both the terms will become positive. So 2x plus 3 into the remaining part, 3x minus 2. These are the factors, so 6x square plus 5x minus 6. In this way we can solve so many questions from different books. You try to solve it. If any doubt, you can ask.
Okay. Ma'am, we have got last couple of minutes left.
Yes.
We are left with only 2 minutes.
Okay. So, last factorization I am explaining. It is a cubic polynomial. So, if we are given a cubic polynomial, simply if common factor is given, very easy to solve, x2 minus 2x squared, where here we can take x squared as a common factor and bracket x minus 2. And here in these two terms, minus 1, now common factor is given, so we can take minus 1 as a common factor, so x minus 2. So here, if we take x minus 2 as a common factor, we got x squared minus 1 as the remaining factor. It can be written as x square minus 1 square. We know what is a square minus b square. That is a plus b into a minus b. Therefore, the factors are x minus 2 into x plus 1 into x minus 1. There are 3 factors for a cubic polynomial. One more is x cube minus 3x square minus 9x minus 5. Here we cannot take common factors. So another method we are using. First we are using factor theorem, that is we are using trial and error method. 1 or minus 1, 2 or minus 2, 3 or minus 2, minus 3 we can put. I am substituting minus 1 because 3 terms are minus, so we are not putting plus 1. P of minus 1 equal to minus 1 the whole cube, minus 3 into minus 1 the whole square, minus 9 into minus 1, minus 5. Here we got the answer as minus 1, minus 3, minus 5. So that is minus 9. Plus 9. 9 minus 9 is 0. The remainder we got as 0. So by factor theorem, x is equal to minus 1. So we can say x plus 1 is a factor. If x plus 1 is a, we got one factor, so we can divide this given polynomial by x plus 1. So x cube is given as the first term. If we multiply this first term x by x square, we get x cube. That is x into x square is x cube. Plus 1 into x square is x square. When we are dividing, we will subtract the terms. X cube minus x cube is 0. Minus 3 minus 1 is minus 4x square. Remaining terms we are written as same. Now the first term is minus 4x square and here it is x. We can multiply it by minus 4x. Minus 4x into x is minus 4x square. And minus 4x into plus 1 is minus 4x. So minus 9x. Here it is, signs are changing. Minus plus cancel. Minus 9 plus 4 is minus 5x minus 5. So when we multiply it by minus 5, we get minus 5x. And plus 1 into minus 5 is minus 1. Signs are changing. So we got the remainder as 0. So we can factorize this quotient also. That is x square minus 4x minus 5. That is x square minus 5x plus x minus 5. Last year we have studied how to factorize this. So taking common factor x into x minus 5 plus 1 into x minus 5. That is x minus 5 into x plus 1. First we got the first factor as x plus 1 and then the remaining factors as x plus 1 and x minus 5. So in a cubic polynomial, we can have 3 factors.
Okay. Ma'am, we'll have to wrap up the session right here. We don't have any more time.
Yes. Okay.
Thank you so much for solving these questions. And I'm sure the math students of 9th class, they must have felt helpful. And I'm sure they were solving the answers too along with you. Thank you so much once again for being with us.
Thank you.
Thank you to all the viewers for watching this program, and I'm sure you enjoyed. Just like this, keep on watching all our programs, and coming up next is a webinar on ICT tool. Well, what is the ICT tool that we are going to talk about? Well, that is Kahoot, and we are going to learn how to create quizzes using Kahoot. So stay with us, and we are coming back after a short while. Thank you so much. Namaste.